Now let's take a minute to see how you can improve your team. Kick off your week by installing your game plan. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. We should have a good one on tap here today. It's the Broncos coming in at 2-2, going up against the Falcons, who come in at 4-0. With that, we'll send it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis. They've got the call in this week 5 matchup.
Okay, Larry, we are located a couple miles west of the Colorado State Capitol building. Here in downtown Denver. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Atlanta Falcons and the Denver Broncos. And hello again, everyone. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it 2 in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Falcons, it's been all systems go in this first month. They're off to a 4-0 start.
And as Gap folks believe that this is a team that's built to go all the way. You can't win the Super Bowl in September, but they're telling everyone that they're going to be there in the end.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by a man in his 9th year already out of Boston College. It's Matt Ryan.
And there's no way that Matt Ryan is ultimately happy about what happened in 2015. His lowest touchdown total since his rookie season, he's rededicated and looking for a bounce back season.
They go play action here on first down. Deep drop. And he's got the NFL's leading receiver a year ago, Julio Jones. And even 20 yards and a first down on the game's very first play.
I know that's their first connection in this game, but you and I both know that Julio Jones is without a doubt his quarterback's favorite target.
Oh, yeah, Matt Ryan loves this guy. Who wouldn't?
Yeah, and the reason that he's that is because of his dependability. And quarterbacks have to have that from their receivers, meaning they know where they're going to be when they're running certain routes. They don't break them on them. They don't change them up and do their own freelance stuff and put their quarterbacks in bad situations. Matt Ryan has ultimate trust in Julio Jones.
Now it's and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Brandon Marshall leading the surge there. He drops in for a loss of 6. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out, you see, and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. 0 accountability, and a sack resulted. And the Broncos go to a nickel set on third down.
Yeah, they've got an extra DB out there. Third and long, it's Ryan. And incomplete, almost intercepted. The D lineman almost had it. Couldn't hang on.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
So on fourth down, the Falcons will call on Matt Bosher to punt it away. And look here, it's an opening drive fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, they look like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a big stop. Now a play fake here on first down. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. C.J. Anderson, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. Second and 10, it's Lynch again. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Benny Fowler that time. And it's third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on third and 10. On third down, Lynch. And Fowler's got it. And he eventually goes down, but not before reaching the 30-yard line. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is that now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Again on second and 10, it's Lynch. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Simple slant route and partner, really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
Now a carry, it's C.J. Anderson. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. C.J. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Broncos have taken the early lead. So they went to the ground game on third, hoping to pick up the first. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to having a pass block. All right, you're looking at what it is, third down. They don't care that it's third and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you energize them. I think you juice them up because I haven't met offensive linemen yet that likes to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him, and he took it to the house.
They run. Devontae Freeman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 11 on the gain there, and it'll be first down Atlanta. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. He'll buy some time right, and nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away, and it's second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Illegal block in the back. Offense. Still second down.
On second down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. On first down, Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. That's caught at the three. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Jacob Tammy, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. That time, a 6-play drive, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And Denver getting set to take the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn it into a play action, and throw it one deep.
Give them 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn them a fresh set of downs.
C.J. Anderson may not be a Pro Bowl runner, but he knows how to run big in big games.
Yeah, he sort of sealed the Super Bowl for them in the fourth quarter. Big game against the Patriots last year on a Monday night, but only 720 yards all told in 2015. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. Back to Denver right after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before that. Over the middle this time to Fowler. And oh, he coughed it up, and the Falcons grab it. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
Wide open receiver complete. That goes for a gain of 31. And quickly, they get to the line. From the gun, it's Ryan. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Devin Hester, his first touchdown on the year. And the Falcons have taken the lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Yeah, after the touchdown, here's Bryant now to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will take a knee here. So per the new rules in 2016, this will be brought out to the 25-yard line. And now the Broncos offense, they get set to head back onto the field. They'll come out in the pistol. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got it. The ball comes out, and the Falcons grab it. And they have the football, and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On second down, Ryan. The left side completion to Jones. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Falcons will extend their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
It's good, and it is now 21-7. They had the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just 2 plays to get into the end zone. Yeah, after the touchdown, here's Bryant now to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here. I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Second down now after the pass completion. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
Thomas, the lone receiver left. And movement by one of the Broncos up front, and in comes the flag.
False start, offense. Still 3rd down.
Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. On 3rd down, Lynch. He goes underneath for Anderson. And he's got the 1st down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. On 1st down, and seeing no options, he just tosses this one away, incomplete. Now that'll bring up 2nd down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. On 2nd down, Anderson, and he'll get this down only to about the 46. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. From the gun on 3rd down, it's Lynch. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he picks up the 1st before he's taken down at the 29. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well.
Hey, Charles, give me a water. Jeez, Chuck, they cut off the halftime show again. Quicker than anticipated, ready for the start of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken in at the one. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is a I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
After watching that play and result, I go back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator, Brandon, before the game and said, how are you going to move the ball running it against the number one defense? He gave us no indication, didn't tip his hand at all, so we have to see how.
Lynch fighting. He fumbles. He lost the football. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right, a lost opportunity.
Well, nice job on the return there, 16 yards. So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like? And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
He doesn't give many opportunities to carry it. So he's got to maximize. In this case, after dropping it like that, I think his number's going to go way down. What do you think?
Yeah, and sometimes those fullbacks, let's just be frank, they usually don't have the hands that the running back does.
And it's hard for them because they do so much blocking. A lot of times, their hands actually get beat up in the process, and it's hard for them to hold on to the football.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Second down following the run.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So third and seven, and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Now it's Lynch, and he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He'll send this one into the mile-high air, and it's a good one. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Now the Broncos heading back out onto the field. And they forced that fumble the last time, and when it happens on a previous drive, you kind of get thirsty for it to happen again.
No doubt about it, because the person who created the turnover or the takeaway, he's getting the gold star. He's going to be the one we look at in film session and go, way to go. Everybody wants that praise from the coach. That means the next time out, that you want it to be you.
Do they still hand out gold stars?
You know, amazingly enough, it's the simple things in life that more motivate these guys.
A sticker. Just a little.
That's his little helmet sticker in college.
Yeah, put it on your
fridge. NFL, put a little gold sticker on their scouting sheet. Things like that. They love that stuff.
Makes them feel good.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
And now they're in the hurry up.
On second down, here's Ryan. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. So third and medium here, third and five. From the gun on third down, Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And they're going to speed things up here. On second down, Ryan. And the catch is good, the rookie Austin Hooper. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Back now at the home of the champs, Sports Authority Field in Denver. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the fourth. On the counter, Devontae Freeman. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now Ryan on second down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. It's caught. Jones. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish, because strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident.
And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Tevin Coleman, his first touchdown on the year. And the Falcons will add on to their lead.
Well, we got a little bit of everything on that run. Offensive line creating some space, but how about the guy running behind his pads into the end zone?
What does that mean when a guy says running behind his pad? It
means that he's going to be a physical runner. That way he's able to use his shoulder pads, his forearms, anything to ward off people and power his way forward.
He knocks it through. It's 28-7. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. And after the touchdown, here's Bryant now to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out proved somewhat fruitful as he is able to get it across the 25 by a little bit. Time for a break. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On first down, it's Lynch. Over the middle this time to Fowler. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll throw on first down with Lynch. A dump off to Anderson. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. Now Lynch on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Rashid Hageman in there to get him for a loss of 5. On second down, Lynch. He goes underneath for Anderson.
So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On third down, Lynch looking left side and completing it to Thomas. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. Here we go, Lynch on fourth down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and it is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week.
He's got a man complete. Give him 27 yards that time. And that leads to an Atlanta first down. So deja vu all over again. Another good week. And sometimes maybe, because the defense doesn't look that bad, maybe this is just good offense beating good defense in his case.
I like that because we always want to point out that there's a breakdown or someone made a mistake or there was an error. Sometimes it's exactly as you described it. Sometimes they just made better plays. And that's what he's been doing for the last.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Jacob Tammy with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Falcons will extend their lead. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Scoring summary, 3-play drive, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. And after the touchdown, here's Bryant now to kick it away. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Well, in this one, partner, we had some action all the way down to the final whistle there with the late points and then the kickoff to end it.
Yeah, and the best part about it is just seeing how teams battled all the way to the end, you know. Didn't really matter. Scoreboard was pretty well set, but they still competed until the final whistle.
So for Atlanta, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for Denver, they drop below 500 to 2-3 with a loss. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head down to San Diego for a matchup with the Chargers. So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, everyone, as we say so long from Denver.
Off your week by installing your game.